Hey everyone, Sajin Mishram here with a new Cinema 4D and After Effects tutorial about how to create this infinitely looping typography from Cinema 4D and put it all together in After Effects that simulates the views of the scene. Before starting up, if you are new to my channel, please subscribe, like and share. Please watch the video till end. You will see how, although it seems a bit complicated, but following the steps that I am going to indicate, it is really simple. Go for it. As well we know, open After Effects and I'm gonna go File, New here, and we are going to generate a new Cinema 4D project infinite loop. Cinema 4D opens and we are already inside. The first thing we are going to do is to create a text. For that, we'll go where the splines are and select text. The text, as we know, has some of the typical controls of any design program. For example, text center is misaligned left. Let's center it. We're going to change what is written. Let's change it to loop. Get a better idea of what it will look like. Then we'll select font. Let's change it to Montserrat here. Let's make it italic for fun. In this case, there is another aspect to take into account, which is that we are going to touch the kerning a little so that you can see it. Because the kerning in Cinema 4D is something relatively new. It is a bit complicated to understand. The kerning, as well we know, is the distance between pairs of characters. For example, between L and O and O and P. Unlike the tracking that is here, the horizontal spacing, that would be the spacing between all the characters of the word loop, what you see with the naked eye is that the kerning or the distance between the L and the O is a little open or a little too far apart. With this horizontal spacing, here what I have to do is tell it the beginning and then here I have to limit and let's see if I think this is not zero. In the final setting, if I play here, you see the kerning is affecting only the distance between LO and OP. We are going to try to get him into the hole. I believe thus by intuition that this would be the 2 at the start and 3 at the end. Surely here we are. Great, we are playing the kerning between these pair of characters. Well, you see that I can touch the tracking, which would be the horizontal spacing for the whole world. And here, fiddling around a bit, if we put 1 and 2, I think it will even touch the tracking or affect the kerning between LO and OP. Since it is simply a matter of counting how many characters there are. And here we put the parameter that we see directly in the word and that we are going to do next. We are going to open Extrude here and select Extrude and we are going to put our text inside an Extrude. How do we read the text and when we see that the arrow points downwards, do we put it inside or do we make it the child of the Extrude? We'll make it child of the Extrude like this. I put this view like this because now that I'm going to do this extrusion, I'm going to give it a little more depth and the next thing I'm going to do here in showing would be to have some kind of view in which, for example, there is viewport line as you see, that deformation is something like that. Let's see it in the concrete example that we are going to carry out this deformation in depth of the extrusion. I will need to go back to object properties here, change direction to Z or Z, that has detail in Z or in depth, then and apply the extrusion on the object. We have the option here which is subdivision. If I change the display mode, quick shading lines to better get the look at subdivisions. I already have this detail that will allow me to generate these waves or these tails. Let's increase the subdivision. So now, with focusing on the fun part, we are going to generate our wind. It is the wind effector that we are going to use to generate this. And as we normally know, look, we are going to do one thing is to use a cube in this case so that you can see what we are going to do and the problem in case happens that we find when we have. For example, extrusion. Normally, the shapers act as children of the object that they are going to deform. Let's see the detail. So that you can see it, we are going to press play so that you can see the ripple effect it generates. Here I have a problem, and it is that in the extrusion, the text is already the child of the extrusion. So it doesn't allow me to place this here below, because the extrusion will stop working. So there is another way to make deformers act on objects in Cinema 4D, which would be if these objects are inside null objects. Here where we have all the geometries, we have an element that is a null object. We are going to generate it, we change its name. We are going to put waves here, and what we have to do is make a child of the null object, both the extrusion and the wind deformer. And in this case, we are going to erase the cube even if they are at the same height. Everything that is inside this null object is going to be affected by the deformer, and I am going to show it to you. Look, for example, if you want it to also affect this cube, if you put it in here, something like that, and we are going to give it a play. All the elements that were inside the null object would be affected by the deformer. Now, let's select the wind deformer, go to coordinates here below. Now start changing the wind. Let's make pitch valley to 90 degree and bank valley to 90 degree as well. This looks correct direction to me. Now let's play it to check. Great, we are on a right track. Our extrusion is not looking like a wave. So let's increase some subdivision on it. Select the extrusion and go to object properties to increase it. Seems this will work. Now let's go back to wind deformer settings. Here in object properties, change the amplitude of the waves. Increase the size of the waves so that it looks like realistic. Adjust the frequency around 2. Turbulence, I guess, reduce it to lower values. Maybe 0 only will be good. Also increase the frequency in X direction to get a good flow of waves. And last, let's uncheck this flag setting to unpin the text layer. Great! This looks fabulous to me. A perfect wavy flow. Now as our animation part is done, let's add some color to the text. Just double click in the material window and a default new material is created. Rename it as white. To give more retro look to our typography, let's select the material and basic properties, check only luminous box and rest uncheck. Let's duplicate the material by Ctrl C and Ctrl V option. Rename it as black. In this material in basic properties, just uncheck the luminance also. Now, just drag the white material on the extrusion layer here. That's it. Our first material is assigned to the typography. Now duplicate the extrusion by just holding Ctrl key and dragging it. Assign the black material to it and rename it front. As we are going to keep the black text extrusion in front of the wave flow. If you are not able to see the black extrusion, just go to the object properties of it and change the offset value to -1. Also, to get better look, increase the subdivision on the white extrusion. This will give you a depth in the two materials blending. Great, the material world is done now. Now let's add camera to get a point of view for rendering. Go to the top toolbar and add a camera. Let's increase the focal length to 120. This will give a different perspective to our viewer how the render will look like. A type of parallax effect, it gives us the wave flows in distance. We can change the camera window settings to 1080 by 1080. This will help us in After Effects. Now let's save our file and it's time for After Effects. As our file is already updated in After Effects, now select the Cinema 4D file and create a composition with it. There you go. It created a composition with desired setting and all the animation is also there. In cineware settings, keep camera as camera 4D camera. We can see subdivision lines still on the waves, which we don't want, right? For that, in render settings, change viewport draft to current. This will change it to our output look. We are not going to play around with something else very ugly or to do what we want. We have seen how we can generate this type of animations in Cinema 4D and then produce them in After Effects and then output the format as we want. Now say that we would be left it to make a perfect look for it. We will add a background color. Right click and add a solid layer. Define the color for it as you want. Now you remember why we have given a black and white materials to the text flow? Here we have advantage of change it to any color now. Add a tint effect from color correction drop down. Now you can change the matte black and white color to any desired colors which you wish. That's perfect. To make perfect loop, we will put guide here below the letter L and another one here in one of these peaks in this, that it would be or perhaps better in this loop. Let's check the animation by pressing spacebar. Great. That's it. This is the infinite loop effect. We managed to get really crazy distortions depending on how we use the effects. It's a very experimental effect because I want to show that you have to get your hands dirty to find. When you do, look for more effects, try to add and see if you get different or more crazy or more interesting results. I showed my creation process of a typography video from a single word. As you saw, from the techniques that we learned, we are able to create typographic animations with incredible visuals. We have reached the end of the tutorial. I hope you enjoyed and learned a lot during this process. After finishing your video and exporting it out, be sure to share it on the comment section below or tag me on Instagram. I'll be looking forward to give feedback. Thank you so much. I will see you soon. Bye.